Okay, good afternoon, everyone, anyone that might be vaguely interested. I'm going to do a quick video on my latest sort of purchase, which is a Tascam BR20 open reel 10-inch or 10.5-inch reel-to-reel tape deck. I'm really pleased with this. I wasn't quite sure what to expect. It's an eBay purchase, and obviously you never can't be too sure what you're going to get, even with good quality pictures. I had quite a few exchanges of email with the seller, it all seemed good. So anyway, this tape deck, as far as I can tell, has been removed from a TV studio and is in absolutely mint condition. I did quite a lot of reading around prior to buying it, various other tape decks, and in the end I settled on this one. I quite like the slightly industrial look to it rather than the sort of lots of brushed aluminium look, but it is in absolutely mint condition. There isn't a single scratch, there wasn't a speck of dust. The only tiny little marks are where it's been rack mounted, and the screws on the holes on the side on the rack mount flanges have slightly scratched the paint, but I mean that's nothing that putting some screws in wouldn't cover up. So but I've left it as is. It was packaged extremely well, arrived with no problem at all, next day delivery, and it's perfect. So I've got I had a reel-to-reel tape deck when I was a kid. I'm now a lot older than a kid, and I've always kind of liked the look and the sound, so I decided to go for this one. Now, tape wise, I bought some empty aluminium reels, again from eBay. The tape deck was only supplied, oddly, with one nab hub, so I've bought another nab hub from a supplier in Germany, which is a Tascom original, so it matches the one that was already on there. The reels I bought from eBay were already loaded with tape. I think it was Ampex 458 or something, low print tape. Somebody correct me if I'm wrong. Anyway, so I thought I would try that. Now, those tapes said they were recorded back in the early 90s, and it was storybook or voice recording rather than music, which I think tends to be one of the things that low print tapes used for. Anyway, so I thought I'd give it a go and put it through, and kind of after a very short period of time, wished I hadn't, because within only a few minutes I started noticing small flecks of black collecting at the base of the tape deck, and the tape was obviously shredding. I only played it for maybe a few minutes, and when I rewound it, it started squeaking. So then I looked at the transport mechanism. Luckily there was no deposit on the heads that I could see, but there was a build up of sort of black gunk. Not sticky, just sort of flakes of stuff here and there, which it was easily removed with just a cloth and then a quick wipe with some isopropanol. The tape transport, so basically I binned all that tape. Spent all this money on the tape deck, and it's in such good condition I didn't want to ruin it by putting rubbish tape through just for the sake of, you know, not buying some new tape. So the reels, what I've settled on is SM911 tape, which I've sourced from Tape City, no connection with them. So I bought it as pancakes, and then just took the reels apart, the aluminium reels, and then just loaded the pancakes in. It takes just a few seconds. It's really, really easy to do. And rather than trying to spool them off the pancake, and it's the pancakes are cheaper than the plastic reels, which I won't be using anyway. So I thought, well, just buy the pancakes. So I'll just go over the basic functionality. I've got a fairly modest setup here. This tape deck's actually out of my man cave, which is where I wanted it. It sits next to my sort of workstation here, so I've got something nice to look at. Sound system wise, I say it's fairly modest. I've got a Musical Fidelity The Preamp, which I sourced in probably the early 90s. I've got a pair of Quad 405 monoblocks, which I actually built about 20 years ago, they were copies of Quad 405s. You can buy Quad 405s off of eBay now for next to nothing, but I built these from scratch. And speaker wise, again, pretty modest Magnat Monitor C's, which again I picked up when I lived in Germany in the early 90s. which they're not too bad. They produce quite a lot of low range, and they're very bright on the top, which I quite like. So, you know, speakers are in the ear of the beholder, and I like them, so there we go. And it's in my man cave, so I didn't want to go too nuts and buy anything too expensive. Anyway, so all good. Right, I'll go over the basic functions of the tape deck then. Back in a second. Cheers. Okay, back again. Just repositioned the camera to give a better view of the base of the tape deck. I'm not filming the top of the tape deck. I'm sure you know what it looks like. It's got some reels that go around. Right, as I say, it's all extremely clean. I've cleaned the transport mechanism with some isopropanol, although there wasn't really much to clean. Well, not until I put that rubbish tape through it, anyway. Everything runs perfectly, from what I can make out. It's very quiet. Pinch roller, well, I looked a lot online about how to clean pinch rollers, and there's dozens of different thoughts on it. In the end, from sort of experience in cleaning rubber before, I gave the pinch roller a very quick wipe with a lint-free cloth and some methylated spirits rather than isopropanol, but very quick. I got a little bit of deposit off of it, but now it's looks new to me. Pinch roller is in perfect condition, no stickiness and no cracking. So basic functions then. I'll try and do this as best I can. Starting from the left, I've got the service manual and the operation manual for this tape deck, which I downloaded. If anybody wants service manuals, or I'm sure most people know this, but if you don't, there's a website called Hi-Fi Engine, which is, you just register, and they have got pretty much every service manual for everything you can think of. So I got the service manual and the operations manual and the glossy brochures and everything pretty much that they produce for this tape deck, and they're free downloads in quite high quality PDF format with schematics and everything. So yeah, check out Hi-Fi Engine if you want some documentation. Now, from the documentation, I found out the first thing over here on the left, you've got a phones jack, a monitor, and a speed pitch control. Interestingly, this particular deck, you can't quite see it, it's just above the cover here, there's a monitor speaker built into the deck. Apparently, from what I can make out from the manual, that speaker only operates on the US and Canadian version. On this version, the monitor control seems to control the phone's output, and I don't think that monitor speaker actually is working. It's probably would be working. I don't think it's connected on this model. This is the sort of 240 volt mains version, so presumably designed for the European market. Although saying that, it's switchable. I don't know, but the monitor controls the phone's output and not the monitor speaker on the unit. So over here you've got a three position switch, speed mode switch. You can go fixed, which is what I've got it set to at the moment, or you've got an external sort of speed sync input, or vary speed, whereby this pitch controller then controls the speed of the tape within some limits. If you've got it fixed, like I've got it fixed, I've got it tape speed low and high, which I think 7.5 and 15. To be quite honest, I've been just using a 7.5 to save tape. I've tried it at 15 on the equipment I've got, and with my hearing now, I couldn't really tell much difference. I'm sure some people can with the right test equipment, you can, but it sounds absolutely brilliant to me on low, on the 7.5 speed, so I'm just going to leave it where it is. Then you've got input, cow, uncow, output, cow, uncow. So input on uncal allows you to change your input levels using the input controls here, left and right, or channel 1, channel 2. On the output, I just leave it set to cow, and then just turn the outputs down to 0, and it plays back perfectly from the cow setting. You've got EQ, NAB or IEC, so I've got it set to NAB. Reference level, I've got it set to low, which I think is correct for this SM911 tape. Say, to my ears, I can tell an awful lot of difference. I've not set the deck up specifically for this SM911. I've got access to the equipment. I could do it, but to be honest, it sounds so nice as it is. If I switch between input and the reproduction output, it sounds exactly the same. So I'm of the thinking, well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So I'm just going to leave it alone because, you know, it's so nice, I don't even want to take the back off of it, to be honest. It's probably never had the back off since it was made. In the centre here, you've got if you hit these two record buttons, well, they'll flash, which basically means it's armed for recording. So it now will record if I hit record and play together. And obviously they're flashing to let you know that it's armed. If you want to avoid any accidental recording, you just press them so that they go out, and now you can't record, which is quite nice. Then you've got three sets here. You've got input, so you can listen, not surprisingly, to your input. You've got sync, which switches between, it automatically switches to input when you start recording. And then you've got repo, which is obviously for the reproduction head, so you can listen to your playback. Reel size, small and large. So this is set to large because I've got 10.5-inch reels on. And then we come to all this jiggery pokery on the right hand side. And this is quite cool. Obviously, one of the things with tape decks, which is slightly not annoying, but is obviously it's not random access, it's serial access. So this provides you with some basic memory functionality, which then allows you to locate places on the tape. So as standard, you've got three memory inputs. Memo 1, Memo 2, and Memo 3. Any point on the tape you happen to be at, you just hit the Memo button and it just records it into that memory slot. You can check them. If I hit the check button here, it goes dashed, and if I press the Memo button, so that memo is set to 29.32, that one's set to 12.03, and that one's set to 12.17, as in 12 minutes 17 seconds. And you just hit again and then it goes back to zero because I've hit the reset button, so I've zeroed it at the beginning of the tape, just after the leader. Right, so you can do, so basically you can just hit the memo, any of those memo buttons, and it will either fast forward to that point or rewind to that point depending on where it is at the moment. So you hit the location to actually start it running. You've got a return to Z, which is really nice. So once you've queued it up at the beginning, you just hit RTZ and it will rewind back to zero and slow down nicely. I'll show you that in a minute. It's kind of cool. You've got a way of going to any direct location on the tape. You can press direct location and then just dial in the time you want, and then away it goes. You've got a repeat function, which allows you to select any of the two memories. You hit repeat and then it will just play in a loop between those two positions. An autoplay will just start playing automatically whenever it reaches a predetermined position. So right, well, I'll try and play it. I have no idea what it's going to sound like with this. I've got like a little lapel mic, but I don't really know what this is going to sound like. I haven't really messed with this spool. Just sorry, before we go into that, spool rewinds it at a slower speed. First spool storage. I've not messed with edit at all. That in the manual, there's loads of stuff about that. It sort of loops tape out and allows you to splice on the machine. But to be quite honest, I won't be using any of that, so I've not even played with the edit function at all. So if I press, if we go, so if I press, I won't select autoplay to start. If I just press location, actually I'll tilt the camera up slightly, otherwise you won't actually see it doing anything. There we go. Okay, if I press location, there we go, so off it goes. Really nice smooth transport mechanism. Well, I was going to say I haven't got a great deal of experience with open reel tape deck, so it looks smooth to me. The only noise I really get from the transport mechanism is just wind noise on the spools. So it'll fast forward. Just pricked the start of a track, sort of about two-thirds of the way, maybe a bit further through the tape. It seems very accurate when it queues up, so it's now slowing down because it's reaching the predetermined point and stopped. So that, I don't know what this music's going to sound like through this mic, so if it sounds dreadful, apologies. So I hit play.
Quizás
Sorry, I got carried away. That girl's voice is enough to make a man feel old. It's just amazing. Anyway, I've lost my train of thought now. Ah, I was going to show the repeat function. I've stored a couple of locations around a little bit of speech that came from Django by Tarantino. So if I hit the repeat and then I press memo 2, memo 3, off it goes. So I've told it to repeat about memo 2 and memo 3 set points on the tape. And it'll just do that ad infinitum. Well, till the tape runs out or wears out. So it's quite a long way back further on the tape. So it's I picked the tune or the track, just played it towards the end of the tape, and then the loop is at the beginning of the tape. So it's just getting to it now.
Stumbling around in the dark. State your business or prepare to get winged.
And it'll play it again.
Who's that stumbling around in the dark? State your business or prepare to get winged.
And so on forever. So stop that. Take it out of repeat mode, and then I'll just lastly show, I don't think I've forgotten anything, probably have, but there we go, the return to zero, which is really useful. There you go, perfect. So yeah, that probably went on a bit longer than I anticipated, so if anybody's still there, sorry about that. So that's the Tascam BR20, one of my best purchases ever, I think, and I don't think it's a piece of equipment I'll ever get rid of, because it's just too nice. So if anybody's got any questions about it, then yeah, give me a shout. Say I'm no expert, but it's very easy to use and it appears to all work perfectly. So anyway, thanks for watching. Cheers.